jump right into this. First off, I just wanted to give you some resources that are going to be available to you for this entire webinar. During this entire time, please feel free to... Oh, they can't hear us. Yeah, the only problem is it doesn't. Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah, you can try that. All right, hold on, everyone, 1 second. We're going to try to change the sound system a little bit to make us sound a little clearer. All right, we're going to see if this works a little better. I'm sorry about the sound quality. We're going to see if we can fix that in a second. In the meantime, we're just going to jump right into this and continue. And, you know, if you have any questions, just feel free to ask us questions like I mentioned before. And if anything sounds off or if you have problems seeing the presentation or anything, feel free to write that in the question area just so we know, because sometimes we're not really sure if someone can hear us or not. So that would be really helpful. So just to continue real quick, feel free during the presentation at any time to ask questions. You can ask them at the beginning, middle, or end. We do have a dedicated section at the very end of the webinar to go over any questions, so just feel free to ask questions throughout. There are handouts available to you. There should be a few handouts about buying a home and the cost of buying a home, so those are free for you, so definitely download those for additional resources. I don't believe we have any polls in this webinar, so you can just ignore that. And lastly, I want to let you know that the recording will be available to you once the webinar is over. You'll actually get that as a link in your email. So if you have to get up and go to the bathroom or if you have to go do something, don't worry. You'll get a copy of this webinar sent to you. And we're also going to be adding this to our YouTube channel, too. So don't worry. You're going to have this content available to you. And now today, we're going to go over who our presenter is. And we have Raul Cabrera with us today from Integra Real Estate. Raul is a bilingual agent, part of the renowned Cap C brokerage, Integra Real Estate. He is a hardworking real estate agent committed to helping his clients find their dream home, sell their current home, or find the perfect rental. He is a father who just moved into his first home with his wife, so he understands the emotional and financial anxiety and excitement that comes with purchasing a new home. The home of your dreams is more within your reach than you realize, so let's find this together. And with that, I leave it to Raul. Actually, you know, I'm going to actually go over the what we're going to go over, and then I'll leave it to Raul, and he'll actually kick off the presentation. So this is kind of like the overview of what the webinar will go through, and then Raul will actually jump into the first part. So number one, we're going to go over choosing the right realtor and what that exactly entails. Next, we're going to go over where to look for homes. Some people don't really know all the resources available to them. Then we're going to go over what the perfect home means to you and the different criteria for that. Then we're going to go over the difficult steps of buying a home. Some of you may be aware of that from previous webinars, but we're kind of going to go over that again. And then, of course, we're going to have the thank you and the Q&A sections for any questions that you may have. And with that, I introduce Raul to start the presentation.
Thank you so much, Brian. Good afternoon, everybody. How's everybody doing? How's the interweb treating everybody today? Well, I guess there's no sound for me. Okay. Well, in that case, thank you, Brian, for the introduction. I'm going to go ahead and start with the different steps that you will need first in choosing the right realtor or real estate agent. Let me distinguish the two. There are a lot of real estate agents, but only a select few could be called realtor. To become or be known as a realtor, you have to be part of a board, which only by being part of that board, you get designated that designation, which is a realtor. But a real estate agent is somebody different. So with that distinction being made, I'm going to go ahead and start talking about the different steps that you're going to need in order to get your home. So how do you choose the right real estate agent or the right realtor? First, you have to find somebody that's trustworthy, somebody you trust, you know, somebody that's loyal to you, somebody that's going to be there by your side when you have that question, when, you know, you have that phone call that you need to ask, what are the taxes, what are the HOA fees. HOA fees are for condo or condominiums or co-ops, and you need to know that information So you want to have an agent that is a phone call away and somebody that's loyal and somebody you could trust. Now, the second thing is you need to like your realtor. You don't want to be working with somebody that you don't like. Remember that this is going to be the biggest purchase you are going to make, and it's something that is not like a pair of shoes that you're buying. So you want to have a realtor that you get along with, so that way the transition and your search is a smooth one. Now, the second thing is you want to ask for a referral, a family, a friend, or somebody that has worked with a professional in the past. Maybe they could recommend that person or that agent to work with you. Now, the fourth, you need an experienced realtor, because you want somebody that knows what they're doing. Experience is key. You don't want somebody doing heart surgery or somebody doing brain surgery on you when, you know, they just are in the process of learning to do the surgery. You want somebody that, you know, they know what they're doing. So that's the same thing when you're buying a home. You want an experienced agent that knows the process, that knows the steps that you need to take, and guides you in the right direction. Because throughout this process, there's going to be different steps that you're going to need to take, and the realtor or the real estate agent is your point to person whenever you have any questions or whenever you have any concerns about anything. That will be your first go-to person. So experience is key. With that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and go to the next slide. Where do I look for homes? Well, there's many different places where you could look for a home. Maybe where you live at now, somebody is selling a home and you see a for sale sign. That's one way. The most popular way nowadays is to go online and to go to different websites, or by going to an open house. An open house is an opportunity for buyers to go without a real estate agent or with an agent to visit homes that are for sale, and they get the opportunity to preview or view those homes inside without being accompanied by a real estate professional. Websites such as Realtor.com, Zillow, and all the rest are also good places to start looking, but there are no substitute for a real estate agent. These are websites that are made and get their information from our systems, for our central MLS system. I, as a real estate agent or as a realtor, belong to different boards that I have to report to, and I have to abide to their bylaws in order to post a home for sale. Once I post a home for sale, websites such as Trulia, Realtor.com, Zillow, they get that information from my central system or from a system that's designed for agents, and that information transfers to these different websites. So yes, these websites are good, but there are no substitute for a realtor. Going back to the first slide, the experience is key. If you're going at this as do it yourself, or you're going through this website, it might be challenging to navigate and to find what you're looking for. If you are, for instance, going on like Zillow.com and you're looking for a specific type of home, or you're looking for a specific type of area, you know, it might be challenging because there's nobody that you could talk to. You could call the 1-800 number and they'll try to connect you to a local agent, but Zillow itself, they do not have agents that they work with inside their company. Now, the perfect home. The perfect home is different for everybody. For somebody, a tiny home is a perfect home. For another person, a perfect home could be a mansion of 5, 7, 15 rooms, 7 bathrooms. It all depends. So the perfect home is what you determine it to be. But With that being said, in order for you to find your perfect home, there's certain criteria that you must meet. For instance, the number of bedroom, number of bathrooms. If your family size is 6, you need at least 3 bedrooms. 1 bath, maybe 2. If your family size is bigger, then you're obviously going to need a larger home. Style of home. Is it a ranch home? Is it a bi-level? Is it a Cape Cod? These are all different styles of homes. So depending on the style of the home, that's what the home will offer. For instance, a colonial style home will offer you larger rooms. A Cape Cod will offer you a lot of rooms, but smaller. So those are all things to keep in mind. And remember, choosing the perfect home is not a process of selection, but more of a process of elimination. You start eliminating things that do not match your criteria of your dream home until we narrow it down to the perfect home for your needs or your family. Location is also important because location determines, you know, the assets of your job, maybe the schooling system, or different location criteria that you might need for your family. The fourth is the taxes. Taxes, unfortunately for New Jersey, are among the highest. Average tax in New Jersey is about $5,500 per tax for average tax, and it could go as high as 15, 20, and higher. So keeping the property taxes in mind is also important because that's something that you are going to be paying on a monthly basis, and it's in addition to your mortgage. So that pre-approval letter that you have right now does not account for the taxes. You know, you have to account for your taxes, your home insurance, and other things like that. And then the fifth is the condo and townhome and HOA fee. That's in addition to the taxes. So that also adds to the monthly fee. So all of these are different variables that you have to account for and that you have to keep in mind before you select the perfect home for your family. Now, make your own dream home. Finding the perfect home could be challenging because a single home is not going to offer everything that you want. So with that being said, you know, we have to be flexible. If you have a bathroom, maybe you find a home that has 2 bathrooms and one of the bathrooms needs a little bit of updating, or the kitchen needs a little bit of updating, or you have to do minor repairs throughout the house to make that specific home a perfect home, then these are things that will make you flexible in achieving or finding your dream home. And like I said again, I'm going to reiterate this again, there isn't a perfect home out there. Only you make the home perfect. Once you move into it, once you start building your dreams, once you start building those memories, that's when the house becomes a home. So with that being said, I'm gonna pass to the next slide. The most difficult steps of buying a home, you already did it. You already made the first step, which was to start and get your pre-approval and to start and get the process initiated. You are here today, and that is the biggest step. You want to become a homeowner. So that to me is what the biggest step is. So there are some difficult steps or some challenges when you are looking to buy a home. The house search sometimes can be frustrating, the neighborhood knowledge, making the offer, tiny signatures, big surprises, making it all happen. So these are all challenges that could be overcome if you are paired with the right agent, the right realtor. You know, if the realtor or real estate agent is guiding you throughout your home search, he's giving you or showing you homes that match your criteria. The stuff that we talked about before, the number of bedrooms, the style of the home, the location of the home. For instance, If I have a client that tells me they're looking for a 4-bedroom, 2-bath, and they're looking for ranch style, it would defeat the purpose to take the client to see colonials, 3-bedroom, 1-bath, because that is not what they need. It's not what they're looking for. Now, knowledge of the neighborhood is also crucial, because for me, I am the area expert. I am the realtor of, you know, Middlesex. I know the area. I know the different locations, with the different parks, the different highways. All these things are important to have knowledge of, you know, the different activities that happen throughout the neighborhood. Then the third one is making an offer. Sometimes, and most of the times, the highest offer doesn't win. So don't have that notion that if you offer more money, you will get the home. Sometimes the term of the offer will supersede the amount offer. Flexibility of the terms of the offer. When I say flexibility of the terms, I mean if you're not having contingencies. Contingencies are, for instance, if there are minor repairs or cosmetic items in the home, such as paint, or maybe you have a small hole on the wall and you're willing to repair after you close, then these things will make your offer more attractive to the seller, because, you know, you don't have any contingencies and no challenges for the seller to make the transaction smoother. Now, these are all the things that could make your home purchasing process smoother, and it could make it a enjoyable and a pleasant experience, because life is about experiences, and your home search experience should be one of happiness and joy, because again, this is your biggest purchase, and it's something that is not only for yourself, but it's something that you could transfer to your family. It's a legacy that you could leave behind for those that you care about the most. Now, there are here in this slide, this one illustrates the challenges. So to the left, you have the home search without a realtor, and then to the right, with a realtor. So without a realtor, you're going to be spending hours looking for a home, hours of research, hours of not knowing what the market trends are or the values within the market that you're looking for. Is the house that you're looking at, is it truly worth that $400,000, or is it only worth $320,000? Only an experienced realtor will know that information. How would they know? Because as a realtor, I perform a lot of compare market analysis of homes. And what that is simply just taking different homes in different neighborhoods throughout Middlesex and giving it a price, comparing other price within that location and pricing the home in that neighborhood. Now to the right, let's talk about the positives. So with a realtor, the search will be a smoother search. Like I said before, it's a process of elimination and not selection. With the experienced and right realtor, you'll be going to the right homes and right locations with the right number of rooms, with the right tax amount, property tax amount, and with the right location. Experienced realtors also know the market area, and that's also something that is of great value to you as a buyer. And just a side note, as a buyer, the realtor doesn't get paid by the buyer. The seller is the one that is paying the fee or the bill for the buyer realtor. So it'll be a disservice to you not to hire a realtor and do it on your own. Now, the second difficulty, the neighborhood knowledge. We have a thumbs up for a good realtor and a thumbs down for a bad realtor. With a good realtor, most local agents with at least a few years of understanding under their belt, they know the neighborhood. They know what's happening. For instance, in my wallet, I have the mayor of Bound Brook, the mayor of South Bound Brook, and the mayor of Middlesex, just because I live there and I've been through a lot of the events and I've interacted with them. I've only been in that area maybe 3 years, but I've become a local agent. I'm part of that community. So I service the community, and as the community servant, I know the neighborhood. Now, knowing the different districts and schools and zoning is also important to know. But let's talk about not doing it with the right realtor. Without the right realtor, you find yourself in a deserted island. You're looking for water, but you don't know how to get there. If you had the right realtor, he will take you to the well and find you the water, find you your home. Without a realtor, you have to learn these things on your own as you go. For instance, sometimes you might find the right information online, sometimes you might not, because certain events are only posted locally. There's no way that it makes it to the internet. Only a local agent will know. Difficult step, making an offer. Making an offer with the right terms. Again, I'm gonna stress this one more time. Not always the highest offer will win, and offering too high of an offer sometimes is not appealing to a seller, because if you do the opposite, if you offer too low of an offer, it's not considered serious. If you offer too high of an offer, they know you're not serious as well. So the market dictates the price of the home. If you are working with the right agent, they're going to tell you, this is what this home is worth. It could be worth between $300, maximum $350, and no higher than that. If you go over that price, the home will not appraise. Why will the home not appraise? Because it's over the market value. When I say appraise, an appraise means the appraisal process happens after you go under contract on your offer. Bank will send an appraisal to give your house a price, the true market value of that home. Also, making the correct terms on your offer, being flexible on the inspections, that will make your offer win. If you are without a realtor and you're doing these negotiations with yourself, by yourself, then you are taking a risk. You are playing Russian roulette. You know, you don't know what you're getting, how to negotiate. You know, I've been in this scenario many a times. I know how to navigate the process, and I know the process. That's why you need somebody with experience and somebody that's on your side, somebody that you could trust, somebody that you like, somebody that you could call, and somebody that relates to you. I relate to my clients, and that's why my clients are faithful to me, because I always look out for their best interests. I will always put my clients' interests before mine. For me, money and commissions and bills, that is all secondary. Giving the client what they want and what they need is most important. Now, the fourth is the tiny signature, big surprises. Without a realtor and with a realtor, they have brought all the paperwork. When we're talking about paperwork, we're talking about different contracts, CIS forms, we're talking about lead paint, we're talking about home inspections, we're talking about all the different paperwork that you're going to be facing at the time of the offer. It's a lot of jargon. It's a lot of papers that you haven't seen before. That's why I'm here, to explain to them. When I said CIS, that's a consumer intent statement form. So my intent, how am I going to represent you? So I could either be a buyer's agent, a seller's agent, a dual disclosed agent, or a transactional agent. Then you have your standard contract. Then the lead-based paint. Any homes built before 1978 need to get that lead-based paint. And then also, you have your home inspection. By law, you're not required to do a home inspection, but it will be foolish not to get one, because neither you or I have x-ray vision. We don't know what's wrong with that home. We need to go to the area expert to get that assessment for us. I will also recommend that you hire a real estate attorney, not any attorney, a real estate specific attorney. Not criminal law, not any other type of law, real estate, because that's what they do on a daily. They'll be able to guide you. I'm going to go ahead and move to the fifth step, which is making it happen. So now that you have everything, let's make it happen. Are you either going to go with a real estate agent, or are you going to choose to, you know, go on your own and, you know, try to figure it out as you go? Again, I'm going to go back to the analogy of the brain surgery, somebody that, you know, is in the process of getting that degree, and somebody that's, you know, been doing it in New York, NYU, let's say, for 15 years, renowned, a lot of merits. Who would you like operating in your brain? Somebody that's just learning, or somebody that knows what they're doing? So this is the biggest purchase of your life. Don't put it at risk, and don't go at it the wrong way, because we're here to help. That's why we're professionals. That's why we do this every day. And as a realtor, again, I'm a phone call away, and I'm here to help those that might need help.
So with that, we're basically done with the presentation. This would be a perfect time for you to ask any questions if you have any. We're going to be going over that now. I'm just going to go over this, and then Raul is basically going to be the one to answer it. So the first question we have here is, how much should you put down? 20%? If FHA, how much?
Okay, that's an excellent question. Well, I will always recommend to put as much of a down payment as you could do. For a 20%, we're talking about a conventional loan, and I would recommend doing that so that way you're not paying extra insurance for not having the 20%. FHA, you need 3.5% of the down payment to get an FHA approval. Again, I will also recommend that you do 20%, so that way you're not looking at paying extra insurances for not having the 20%.
All right. Another question we have here is, can realtor cover any area in New Jersey, or are they specialized in certain counties?
That's a good question. Yes, I'm licensed to service all of New Jersey. That would be a disservice to you if I said, yes, I will work the whole entire state of New Jersey, because I'm not Superman and I'm not able to split myself at all times. So I'm, again, the local expert. I work Middlesex County and Hudson County, and those are my areas of expertise, and those are the two counties that I service because of logistics. It will be hard for me to service somebody in Ocean County when I'm doing all my business out of Middlesex.
Alrighty. I don't see any other questions here, so we're going to just continue on. So if you do have any questions and you didn't have a chance to ask it during this webinar, please feel free to reach out. In a second, you'll have the contact information of the presenter, and you'll be more than happy to reach out with any of your questions there, or you can always email us to at info@greateralliance.org. But I'll give you that information in a second. I just want to let you know that for participating in the webinar, we would also ask if you could fill out a survey. That would be really helpful for us. Right at the end of the webinar, once it concludes, you'll actually be prompted to fill out a survey. if you can, it would be really helpful if you can fill this out. It helps us make our webinar experience even better, and we're always trying to make these experiences better for everyone, so it would be really helpful. And on top of that, you have a chance to win a $25 gift card, so hey, why not, right? This is the perfect opportunity for you to get feedback for us and then have a chance to win $25. So again, we really appreciate that. And then finally, we want to thank you for attending and participating. Make sure to follow us on our social media channels on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube. We're recently on Instagram as well. Just remember, you're going to get a link to this webinar sent to you through email just in case you missed it or for whatever reason you had to get up. So don't worry, you're going to have that. It's also going to be on our YouTube channel. And here's the information for Raul, our amazing presenter. So here's his email address and phone number if you need to reach out to him. And he's always available to answer any of your questions or anything like that, right?
Yes, correct. That is correct. Just before we end, because we have a little bit of time, I wanted just to touch back on some of the slides that we talked about. We talked about open houses. We talked about finding the right agent, finding the right criteria, a lot of information to digest in an hour. So that's why this information is here. So that way, once you have digested all that information and you have all your information, you could reach out to the correct parties. Again, we're here to help you in your home search. We're here to guide you on the biggest purchase of your life. And we want to make this purchase or this process exciting for you, exciting for your family. And we want you to create those dreams. Our job is to find you the house where you could create and build your dreams. And you don't want to leave this process to anybody. You just don't want to hire Joe Smo off the street and, you know, just got his license 2 days ago and he doesn't know what he's doing. You want to hire somebody that's experienced, somebody that's partnered with the right team. Like for me, I'm partnered with Great Alliance. I'm partnered with CAPC, USA, Integra Real Estate, which is our mother our brokerage. You want to have professionals by your side at all times. You want to have people that know the industry inside and out, you know, have counseling experience. If you have somebody that has this question and nobody else could answer, we have housing counselors here at Affinity that could help you answer those questions. Yes, Great Alliance. We have different counselors here at Great Alliance that could help you, you know, answer those questions that you might have. So again, we're a team of people, and it's just not a realtor that makes all of it happen for you, but the realtor or the real estate agent is your point to or go-to person when you have a question. They will guide you and steer you in the right direction. If you have an agent that is not doing that service for you, you could fire them. You don't have to stay with that realtor unless you sign an exclusive agreement with that realtor or that real estate agent. You are open. You could shop around and find the agent that, you know, matches what you are looking for and the pairs with you, you know, somebody that you like. You want to add something, Ryan?
Nope, I think that's it. Thank you again, Raul, for coming and presenting. I hope that everyone here had a lot of information that they found valuable. Again, Raul's information is here. This is his email, just a phone number. Please feel free to reach out if you have any questions or you would like to discuss any of these details in more detail. So, again, thank you again for attending and participating. We look forward to seeing you in our next home buying webinar series, which hopefully will be in the fall. So keep an eye out on our website and social media channels for information on that. So thanks again, everyone, and have a great day.
Have a great day. Thank you. It was my pleasure.